couple of years.
No, I wasn't.
So what's the saying about people having hobbies? A project check to begin with. Anyone here who wants to go home and do some flower arranging? No. Anyone who really likes jigsaw puzzles? Anyone who's really going to come down tonight because they could stay at home and sort of their CDs in alphabetical order? You see, nobody has a hobby in Hong Kong. Everyone until the collapse of the markets and finance, all those fun chills and things like that. No time for a hobby, apart from maybe sweating or standing on the MTR or rubbing themselves against the table. You did, didn't you? But ask yourself, is perspiration really a hobby? You know, you need something to fill the dark void where your life should really be. And I was like that, and I was thinking, what could I have? What interest in the little pastime, you know, to take the days away from me? And I thought, I know, I need to get fit. I need to get some fresh air, right? What I'll do is I'll start marathon running. Because that's impressive, you know, if you can run for 26.2 miles, people think you're quite an achiever, quite a wonderful person. But it turned out to be a rubbish idea. Really, really quite stupid, because marathon running is just hard, takes a long time, and I don't want to beat around the bush, but bits of your body start to rub against other bits of your body. And they start to chafe. And you're wearing these stupid clothes, and you're chafing. You get a nasty rash, and things might fall off. You know, this is not an attractive thing to happen in life. And okay, that's no problem. You can cure that with Vaseline. And I think, you know, really, exactly. If the answer to the question is Vaseline, the question was wrong. And more to the point, think about this. Strange clothes, chafing, Vaseline, a night in one chai is not a hobby. Well, come to think of it. Actually, I've spent a lot of time in one chai recently, but I only go there for music. Yeah, it's true. I only recently played one of the great articles about cars, finance, and so on. And I would go there for other stuff, but I'm not sure what you go to one chai for. I mean, you've got all these stars full of guano tourists and business women. And again, not to beat around the bush, but I was kind of confused. I thought the whole deal was more than a sort of in-out transaction, you know, plenty of bang for your buck, and you know, a good start. But instead, there's all these guys hanging around these bars with these wonderful acquaintances of theirs they've just met, talking. All night. What do they talk about? You know, I mean, really, what do you have in common with a prostitute a quarter of your height? You know, he's older than me and more mature and wise and rich and close to dying. I've got feelings too. I was thinking, you know, maybe I could chat them up. I could find one I like, so I could rock up to go, hi. Banged in the Austrian tourist lady. Stupid idea, it would never work, you see, because chat up lines never work. You know, well, they never work for me, you know. Don't hear any pity, nobody goes, nobody feels sorry for me. But it's true, chat up lines, they work. I mean, I can see how they're meant to work. Again, you find somebody you like, I won't pick on you again, but it's your male, actually, that would be so much. No offense. I'm sure you're a perfectly attractive chap, but it's just not for me. You can find one you like, and look her in the eye and say, hi there, have you got any Irish in you? And you don't want to say, so you don't say anything. Yeah, and then she says no, so I go, would you like some? Back of the net. It doesn't work that way. I get confused. I sort of stumble over my words and start worrying what I'm talking about, and I look at you and go, hi. Would you like me to put some Irish blood inside you? A demented and kind of confused blood transfusionologist is not attractive to women in general, I discovered. And after a while, I thought, well, maybe the problem is it's a language barrier, right? Maybe the problem is I'm speaking English. You know, because everyone can speak English, you know, particularly taxi drivers, they just pretend not to understand it. If I speak a different language, that would impress people more. I have a sort of wonderful accent, some kind of allure. And I thought, the harder the language was, the better it would be, right? I thought, yeah, I'll do it. I'll learn Japanese. That's meant to be quite hard, as languages go. There's 15 different ways, in send order of politeness, about asking your mother to wash your sock. That's it. 4 years of my life wasted. So I left Tokyo last week, and I discovered, quite quickly, you don't need to speak Japanese to understand Japanese people. You need to speak English with a really bad Japanese accent. Okay. Two obvious words, useful ones, for example, like beer. What's that in Japanese? Beer. Cheese. Cheese. Restaurant. A restaurant. Ah, so. The Japanese are so lazy when it comes to misappropriating other people's foreign languages. They've got no will of their own for simple English concepts like futon, or karate, or karaoke. Just lazy little. you can tell, I'm quite an angry person, really. I'm filled with bile, rage, and jealousy. But a couple of weeks ago, something amazing came over me. Kind of religious transformation, you could say. It's changed the whole way I see life and how I deal with people. And I think from the inside out, it's going to change me a much better person. But I've made a commitment to something beautiful. 2 years of internet broadband. I'm glad most people take me seriously, because this is a big commitment. The longest I've had a girlfriend was a year and a half. Isn't that? She broke my heart and she stole my toothbrush. Whereas PCCW, not a week had gone by, and they were showering me with presents. Now, you might say to me, you know, that a USB memory stick is not the most romantic of gifts. But I will remind you, it is the fault that counts. I'm sure as time goes by, as we get to know each other better, there will be other more wonderful things. Maybe I'll come home and find my modem is wearing stockings. So I was telling my friends about this, and they said, no, this isn't right. The most important relationship of your life can't be with the internet. They need a girlfriend. I thought, hang on, this is the 21st century. What do I need a girlfriend for? If I've got the internet, I've got 24 megabytes of pornography spurting over my apartment every second of the day. They said, you're a pervert. I said, so? They said, well, what would your parents think? And I didn't know, so I phoned them up, and my aunt. They're not talking to me ever again, but Christmas is 6 weeks away, that's two less presents to buy, and the current uncertain financial climate, I think that's a wise decision. Oh, I got to thinking, maybe I did need a girlfriend. Because there's things you can do with a girlfriend, right, that you can't do by yourself. You know, you can stare dreamily into each other's eyes. You know, we can skip together through meadows. Gaily. We can stand two abreast of escalators and not let anyone get past. And the trouble is, I'm not sure how to find a girlfriend. Because it used to be easy in the old days, you know. You people over there especially. You go to the bar. You drink 12 pints of beer, quite strong lager, hopefully, and you find your mouth is getting dry. You wake up the next day, and you find your mouth is really dry, say right now, and your stomach's turning, and your head really hurts, and you can't move your arm, because there's a woman lying on top of that. And you don't know her name, or know where she came from, but she's probably about 6 hours pregnant. It's not respectable. I can't do that. You know, I'm a captain of industry now. Look at me, I've got a colour-coded lace suit. Better way for me to meet women. And I thought, but hang on, I've made this big investment in the internet, right? Maybe I can combine the two. Maybe I can have a girlfriend via the internet. So I went quick discovery. I don't know what you're thinking, though. It's not anything disgusting with that. But I found a website called Craigslist, which advertises two things. Furniture and desperate women. Unfortunately, it didn't turn out what I expected. Half of them wanted one thing, a really long list. Height, weight, girth, disposable income, how many children you want to have, what kind of dog. I thought, no, that's not for me, that's too specific. The other half called things like candy, who wants to have sex in Kowloon right now? Not grammatically correct, and candy wasn't spelled correctly, a real turn up to me. So, you may be surprised to hear this, maybe, possibly Jessica as well, I'm still single. But, if any of you want to come back to my place tonight, sit on a second-hand sofa, and download high-speed pornography, so I could be your man. I'm very cool.